What's My Line? Brought to you by Kimberly-Clark, makers of new Kleenex designer towels. Dress-up towels that absorb more because they're two layers thick. And now, let's all play What's My Line? And now, live from New York, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, star of the Broadway stage, soon to appear in a television special with Donald O'Connor, Miss Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. It's my great pleasure tonight to introduce a very talented actor, comedian, whose new picture is called Bang, Bang, You're Dead, Mr. Tony Randall.
And now a very dear friend, who next month will star in the Playhouse in the Park in Philadelphia in the time of the cuckoo, Arlene Francis.
And now a gentleman who embodies the good neighbor policy in the country and whose little wife is waiting for him anxiously in Mount Kisco. Anxiously because she doesn't know what he's going to do after the show tonight. Mr. Bennett, sir.
And here, just back from a Water Pollution Commission meeting out in San Francisco, is that garrulous gadfly of ours, John Charles Patrick Crowan Daly.
Actually, Bennett, thank you. It was the Air Pollution Control Association annual meeting, and I think you ought to know that they had one panel that discussed for an entire afternoon Bennett Cerf's puns.
What's that got to do with pollution?
Clearing the air.
That clears the air. Now we can get to it. Tony, nice to see you. Phyllis, nice to have you
thank
with
you.
Us.
Nice to be here.
And some good occupations, and a little bit later on, we'll have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel. Right now, let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? XX tree. Right? Miss X, will you tell us where you're from?
London.
From London. Nice to have you with us. Panel, may I present Miss X, and needless to say, there are reasons which we think are good and sufficient why I would not tell you any more than Miss X. Now, would you join me over here, please, ma'am? And we will let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. All right, panel, we can tell you that Miss X is self-employed and deals in a service, and we will begin things with Bennett, sir.
Well, Miss X, unless you're deliberately trying to fool us, which you probably are, I would suspect that you had something to do with either singing or dancing. Have you?
No.
One down, and back you go. Miss Newman.
Miss X, you look groovy. That's how we say it in this case. Do you have anything to do with the world of fashion or design?
Yes.
Did you design what you're wearing?
Yes, I did.
You do what you do in England?
And, well, yes.
Well, are you a designer of clothes?
Yes.
What do I have to do now?
I'm not going to wear one.
I don't know.
I mean, I'd love to put that dress on. It's terrific.
Yeah, well, I guess that I'm done in, or I guess we're done in, because you put your finger on it.
May now, I make a guess, though?
Yeah.
First, I was interested to hear there was a dress. I thought it was an old-fashioned bathing suit.
It's your dry. So you go in for a swim, and then you come right out and say.
And it shrank on you, poor child. But anyway, in any case, I was in London last week, and a dress designer received the Queen's honors.
Oh!
Is that who this lady is?
That is exactly who. I'm sorry, Miss Cross. It's Mary Cross. Mary Cross. She is the leading
Mary Quant.
British mod fashion designer. Last week became a member of the Order of the British Empire, right?
OBE?
That's right. OBE, which is a signal honor for the contribution she's made to fashion in Britain. It's also generally accepted that Miss Quant had much to do with making what has been described in recent months, London, the city in, or the capital of good fun in the world these days. Bright, gay, daring, and lots of wing-ding and whiz-ding and groovy, right?
Yes, it is groovy. We were there not too long ago, and the clothes look terrific on the young English girls, I must say. Your
good.
Clothes are great.
Good, thank you.
But she's here to show her fall collection for J.C. Penney, which is nice because they were the first people with whom you worked in the United States back in...
Oh, yes, sir, about four,
is that a
four
mini
or five
skirt?
Years ago, and she stayed with them.
That's not quite a mini skirt, is it?
Yeah, almost.
Almost
a
miniskirt.
Mini
would you get up, Miss Quant, and let it turn around?
Yes,
well, it's...
Would you pretend you're running after a bus?
Well, if you, when did you get into New York?
Well, now it's 4 o'clock or something in the morning tonight.
Oh,
can
yes.
Can I have some scrambled eggs, please?
Oh, you certainly can. That old biological
right.
clock problem. You're
yes.
going to have a couple of days to catch up. Well, how nice of you to come and visit us so quickly after your arrival. And congratulations from all of us in the OBE.
To
nice
see
to have you.
Back.
Thank you. We'll have another contestant for you in just a moment after this word. And now to meet our next contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Cecil Ellis. Right, sir? Something straightened out. It's Cecil, not Cecil, so it's Cecil. Mr. Cecil Ellis. Where are you from, sir?
I'm from originally from England.
Ah, now?
Now from Connecticut.
From Connecticut.
Middlefield.
Nice to have you, Mr. Ellis. May I present our panel? Now, would you join me over here, sir? We'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Ellis is self-employed and deals in a product, and we'll begin things with Phyllis Newman.
Mr. Ellis, is the product something that I might use?
Yes.
If I used it, would it do something to me that would make me happy?
Yes.
Is it a product that I could hold in my hand?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Randall.
Is it a product that is consumed?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Is it a product that one would find in the home?
Yes.
If one had it, would it be apparent? Would one see it as one goes into a house?
Not necessarily, no.
That's three down and seven to go. This is not to say that if you were to be in the right place in the house, you would not see it, but you asked the question in the context of coming into the greeting area, the sitting room.
Is that how I asked it?
Well, that's what I thought, yeah. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Ellis, you said you were from Connecticut, but neglected to say what town. Would you tell us what...
Middlefield.
Oh, that doesn't help at all. Mr. Ellis, does your product... Is a fly buzzing around?
That's my fly, Bennett. You send him back right over here. I've been fighting with him all afternoon. Get out of here!
Mr. Ellis, does your product make the house in any way more comfortable... or pleasant?
If the context here is, does it add to the enjoyment which the residents in the house have available to them and therefore make the house more pleasant, the answer most certainly would be yes.
Does your product have anything to do with the atmosphere or temperature of the house?
No.
No, not the temperature of the house. Four down and six to go, Miss Newman.
If I had this product in my house, would I use it in either the kitchen or bathrooms?
Neither.
That would make it five down and five
that
to go.
That means not the kitchen or bathrooms,
Mr.
all right?
Randall.
Was it established that the fly comes to the person who's on camera?
Tony, do you realize it's taken us 17 years to train that little devil to do that?
He wants his family to see him.
Is he waving?
I'll wave for him. Anyway, has it been established that this is a useful product?
I don't believe the question has been asked.
I don't think I'm going to ask it. I'll leave it for Arlene.
Is it a manufactured product?
Yes.
Does it have moving parts?
No.
That makes it 6 down and 4 to go, Miss French.
It has no moving parts, and you wouldn't see it when you come into the house. And it's not in the kitchen or the bathroom.
And you can't hold it in your hand.
Is it anything that you can sit on or in?
Yes.
Does it hold one person at a time?
It could.
Would I be correct in assuming that water doesn't run in it?
It could be a sauna bath or something. It's
not
just
down in the
minute.
Kitchen.
A sauna bath would be down in the kitchen.
I object. You can install a sauna in your bathroom.
You shouldn't.
Oh.
No, you can have it adjacent to, but you would not have it
yes,
in.
Yes, you can, because some man told us that we could put a sauna in our bathroom.
They just wanted to tell you what.
I'll bet he told you could hold it in your hand.
Well, it was obviously a son of a gun.
What did you say, Bennett?
I said he was a son of a gun.
Now I know why the Air Pollution Control Association is after him. No, but it's funny because, Mr. Ellis, I sat here, you said it 3 times without realizing that you had it.
I didn't think so I had it.
The audience in the theater let go.
In the
Mr. Cecil Ellis, needless to say, is Cecil Ellis Sauna Corporation, right?
Right.
And guess how Mr. Ellis got into this? Mr. Ellis's wife is Finnish and persuaded him way back, what? In the 40s.
Oh, back in the 30s.
30s to yes. Try it, and he found it so salubrious and comforting and fine that he got into the business.
Oh, it's
and
marvelous.
He's the originator of it, really.
Mr. Ellis, I want to give you a free ad, but how much does a sauna cost to install?
A good sauna costs about $2,000.
Oh, boy.
How much is a bad one?
There are so-called miniatures that are appearing in this country, but which are frowned on in Finland. Considered a joke in Finland, in which you can go one person at a time. We don't consider that a sauna.
You like group sauna.
That's yes, indeed.
But actually,
steam,
you can build one, an adequate one for $1,000.
Yes, you can build one for $1,000.
But for a really good one, you know, with typewriters and television and all that sort of thing, they can go all the way up to $3,000, depending on what you put in them. That's what it is. The principle is dry heat, as you all know. And, I wish we had one for the fly. And Mr. Ellis, thanks very much for being our guest. We had
a lot of fun.
Thank you. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message. And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which, as you I guess are all well aware, the panel is blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you enter Mystery Challenger and sign in, please? Gentle reminder, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin things with Tony Wren.
Are you a movie star?
Well, I wouldn't be giving you a lie on that.
Which means yes or
that,
no.
That means yes. Miss Francis?
Are you
currently playing in a picture on Broadway?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Do you ever appear on the legitimate stage as well as in movies?
Oh, yes, a few times.
Miss Newman?
Are you sort of a romantic and voluptuous leading lady kind of lady?
Well, that's a very nice description, I'd say.
I mean, you're a romantic leading lady.
Mm-hmm, I'd say. Yes. Mr. Randall? Are you blonde?
Oh, yes.
Miss Francis?
Are you at the present time preparing to play in the summer theater?
Yes.
As a matter of fact, are you playing right now up very near Arlene's home in Mount Kisco? Which is, in case you don't know it, about 20 miles from Tappan Zee.
Yes.
Well, should we all say it together?
Carol
Baker. Yes. Miss Carol is starring in Anna Christie at the Tappan Zee, through Saturday, right?
Yes, that's
through the
right.
Second of
I was hoping the question would come around to me again, because I was certain it was Carol. I was going to ask my favorite question of her.
What?
Did I once save your children in a hurricane?
Yes, as a matter of fact, out on Fire Island, and Tony saved the children. He
I
came
sort of
by in the fire truck.
The Coast Guard helped me.
Yes.
Well, who saved you,
Carol? Yeah,
I was gone already. I left early.
Really? I mean, this was...
We were all rounded up and sent in, and I grabbed your kids and threw them on the Jeep. That's all I did.
That's right.
Well,
don't
good,
be so modest about your life, say.
Good boy. That's very nice. I didn't... Well, when was that? Now, we haven't had one...
Not 2-3 years ago.
That's right.
A little longer. I think it was about 4 years
about
ago.
4 years
That's
ago.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Are you playing someplace besides the Tappan Zee?
Well, we've played Anna Christie out on the West Coast, and we wanted to get some reactions on the East Coast. It's a wonderful play.
Oh,
delighted
fine.
To do it. But this summer, I'm going to try my first musical. I'm going to do Gentlemen Prefer Blondes several places, Indianapolis and Dallas. I'm looking forward to that, too.
Mm. So, Indianapolis and Dallas, I'm sure. Well, thank you very much. You're busy on stage, and I know this should be your night off.
Yes, this is my night off.
Glad you gave it to us.
Thank you, John.
Thanks very much. You're on Balls of Fire tonight. You've done very well indeed, panel. We'll have another contestant after this word. And now, another contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Kathy DeBell, right? Is it Miss or Mrs. DeBell?
Miss.
Miss DeBell. And where are you from?
From New York.
From New York. Nice to have you with us. May I present the panel? Miss DeBell. And now will you join me over here? We'll let the audience in the theater, the audience at home, know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Miss DeBell is salaried and deals in a service, and we will begin things with Arlene Francis.
Miss DeBell, I must tell you what Bennett just said as you walked in.
No,
it's so terrible. It is. He said, when you walk in the house, you ring
the
bell. In the house, you ring the bell. It's awful, isn't it? Could I use your service, Miss DeBell?
Yes, you could see it.
You could benefit from it if your particular area of interest were to gather you into that particular area of activity.
May I gather from all of that Miss DeBell is a performer of some kind?
No. That's one down and nine to go, but that fly is here and he's a great performer. Where is he? Mr. Sir.
Miss DeBell, do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
No.
Two down and eight to go. Miss Newman.
Pardon me, Mr. Bell, if I availed myself of your service, would I come to you?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Randall.
Mr. Bell, you look as if you might be very athletic. Am I right in assuming that has nothing to do with your service?
Not necessarily, no.
The nonprofit organization you work for, is it governmental?
No, it is not.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Mr. Bell, is there anything religious connected with your work?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Is there anything educational concerned with your work?
We like to think so.
Yeah, then we would agree, Bennett, that in connection with it, there is an element of instruction for those who would be seeking knowledge and who took the initiative to go and find it. Yeah, that right here. Go see Bennett. Go on, scoop.
Mr. Bell, has your service got anything to do with either marriage or children?
No, it does not.
Six down and four to go, Miss Newman.
Now, Mr. Bell, you would come to me then if I wanted your service. Is that correct?
No.
Well, I would neither come to you and you wouldn't come to me.
I would say here that you're right. We would have to, in stretching the rubber, we'd have to say that the service
would each other.
Come to you because of initiative which you took to take advantage of it.
Okay, now, let's sort of go back because I really don't know where we are. I call up and I say, hey there, Mr. Bell, I need you to do something. Would you then...
Well, you see, right there, you're just about 100 degrees off course.
would you instruct me...
This is a service which you can take the initiative to use, if you so choose.
Now, this is sort of a wild, far-out idea. If I dialed a number, would I get a prayer or something? Or some information, you know?
Of course, it depends a lot on what kind of number you dial. That's seven down, three to go, Mr. Wren.
I'm still after the nonprofit organization, and education is concerned with it.
An element. Now, we'd suggest there is a relationship, but I wouldn't lean on it too hard.
It is not governmental. It is not religious. It is not primarily an educational institution.
It's not profit-making.
That leaves... That leaves Arlene Francis to figure it out.
There's a hooker in here. I must tell you that right off the bat, as you probably have guessed by now. It's a rather special situation.
A non-profit hooker.
A non-profit hooker is exactly the way to put it.
Mr. Bell, are you in any way associated with Washington? In any way?
No. Abraham Lincoln or Thomas Jefferson? Neither. Two to go, Mr. Sir.
The government's got nothing to do with this, and the educational system has nothing to do with your work, whatever. Are there any animals involved in this?
There could be, actually. There could be. I'm going to throw the cards over, because this is good fun. The real hooker in here is that Mr. Bell is a sports writer, but works for the Associated Press, which is a non-profit organization.
Oh,
it's a mutual organization.
Yeah,
a dirty trick.
No. Well, I thought it was, but isn't it a nice dirty trick? Huh? And Mr. Bell has been with the Associated Press for 4 years. Lucky Associated Press, but you're going to Baltimore?
Yes, sir.
You work for a paper in Baltimore?
Yes, the Baltimore Sun.
The Baltimore Sun. Now the Baltimore Sun is the lucky one. See? That's the way it goes. But that was fun. We stuck the panel, and I think that's a fine thing to have done. And thank you for helping us.
And thank you.
And thanks to the Associated Press. The only one who really won tonight was the fly.
Yeah.
Phyllis and Tony, it was great fun having you with us.
Thanks
for being with us. And come again, and good night, Phyllis Newman.
Good night. Good night, Tony.
Good night, Phyllis.
Good night, Arlene.
Good night, dear Tony.
Good night, Bennett.
Let's raise a fund for the Associated Press, those poor fellows. Good night, John.
He's going to be mad for the rest of the week. Mad for the rest of the week. I can't contemplate anything more joyous or giving me more spontaneous than Bennett's going to be mad for a whole week.
Then how come the Associated Press is nonprofit if we have time to get it?
Because it's a mutual organization. There are member papers to it, but there is no profit. They just assess the papers to defray whatever costs there might be in. And thanks to all of you for being with us on What's My Line?
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. This is Johnny Olson speaking.